600. So I got a couple of digital images here, but they show some of the aspects I wanted to show. One of the things that we wanted to do with this boat was to design a boat much more for the world market. The 3200 that we did sort of specifically for the French market, for some of the French transat racing and short-handed racing. One of the things that's happened in the last 5 years since we did that boat is that short-handed racing and ocean sailing and ocean racing has become much more popular worldwide. And in fact, now the 3200s, about 40% of them are now sailing in France. The majority of them now are sailing elsewhere in the world. And so it's become a much more international boat that we were looking for. And one of the things that very quickly became apparent was that French people will cross the Atlantic on a 32-foot boat, but most people think that's kind of small. So for us, the next step was to move up in size into that 35, 36-foot range, which when you look at the racing market is a real heart of the market. We wanted to stay away from going much larger because when you get up into 40 feet, the budget and what you need to operate the boat, sail sets, the people that you have to get on board every weekend is a whole different world. And the other thing that we saw, and that was certainly something that came more from the markets elsewhere in the world, was that it wasn't, even though the people were buying them to do shorthanded sailing, they were often mixing both shorthanded sailing and crewed programs, or in some case, fully crewed programs all the time. And the 3200's cockpit, which had been designed to be smaller and more manageable, it was an issue once you put, you know, seven big people in there. So you'll see the way that the cockpits have been laid out is much, much more open feeling to the cockpit. And the second thing, which is an adaptation certainly for the market here, is the ability to move over, if you want, also to the twin wheels. So you can see in this here you have the twin tiller design or twin wheels with the mobile footrests that come in with the twin wheel setup. Otherwise, the rest of the boat is very similar. And you have the possibility of doing either straight sheeting from the cockpit or to have a second or a third set of winches, which create a German sheeting type setup. And again, that's really dependent on people are using the boat for crew or not. A better view of the wheel version here with the movable footrests here, the main sheet coming back here with the main sheet trimmers, footrest here forward, backstay, and fine-tune adjustments. So you have a very easy main sheet position just forward of the helm. And the other thing is that the boat was something that we wanted to design strictly for IRC racing, which at the time we did the 3200 was still an evolving rule, was not very well accepted throughout the world. It's become sort of the world standard, not only for inshore racing, but also for offshore racing. So the idea of making a boat that is an IRC racer means that you can take it throughout the world now. You can race offshore, you can race inshore, you can race Wednesday nights, you can do all kinds of things with an IRC boat that is really optimized for IRC. Down below, we wanted to do several different changes from the 3200. Most notably was the absence of a lot of the wood that we took out of the boat. So we have a boat that has all infusion bulkheads. The deck is an infusion deck with foam core. The hull is actually incredibly high-tech. It's what we call one-shot infusion. It's when you infuse both the hull itself and its structure, which means that you lay up into the mold all of the cloth that you would use to build the boat. You lay in the foam stringers that have been machined to fit into the various places, so you lay it on the entire grid. You cover that in all of the various glass fiber mats. You put down your plastic wrap and you inject the entire piece, which means that when you take that away, you have the hull and its structure done in the one shot, which is what you see on the high-end Grand Prix race boats. It eliminates having an inner liner to the boat and eliminates all of the weight associated with gluing in of the inner liner. So it was a way that we kept the weight down the boat. And we used some of that weight to dress up the interior a little bit more, which was to create this. This is an inner liner, but it's not structural, which allows you to have a much better finish to the base. And we did an inner liner just in the main saloon, so from the back bulkhead to the front to dress up the interior of the boat a little bit compared to the 3200, where we used a sort of a thickened epoxy mix overhead. So it really has a much nicer, much more finished feel on the interior, all the while being keeping it to its weight and structure. Couple of photos of the boat. I think I have a video as well. Our program in France is we'll be racing the boat. Well, I don't know. They'll do it with professionals, but they'll have it racing in the spring series that is in the French Atlantic coast. and it is being raced by the number two guy at North Sails, who's the head of North Sails Europe. So he's very nice sails for the boat. Don't know if you, I don't know how much time you've spent covered in 3DI sails and so forth, but it's it feels like money, you know. But they're very, very nice, and he's putting the boat together for us. It was his personal project, so it wasn't something we didn't have to pay him to do it. He was looking for a boat, and we were looking for somebody who knew their way around a race course, so it came together very well. So he's helped us a lot in terms of getting the boat out there, and one of the things that they do very well at North Sails is that they put together a full tuning guide for the boat, and that's something we didn't have on the Sunfast 3200, and that tuning guide really gains you basically a whole season of playing with the boat. You know, people don't have a lot of time today, and the tuning guide that it'll be doing won't be North Sails specific. You can obviously have it and buy North Sails, and they'll be optimized for the boat, but you can also use the tuning guide with any other set of sails. It's not...
Eric, for those who don't know, can you just speak a little bit of the success of the 3200?
The 3200 right now is a boat that we've done 160 boats. When we started the project, we would have been happy doing about 60 boats, so we've done far and above what we had expected to do. The boat in this first couple of years was racing a lot on the French Atlantic coast, as well as the Transquadra race, which is a solo and double race across the Atlantic. In those first races and so forth, we were often placed first, second, and third, so we had a very good results on those boats. Since then, they've gone off to race in races all over the world. If you get onto our site, and I'll talk about it here in a little while, the sunfast.fr site, which is a .fr, but it's in English and in French, and it you'll see some of the news there from Australia, from the UK. The boat twice has won the Round Britain race, which is around the entire British Isles, which you can imagine is not the friendliest sailing. It's not like going around the Mediterranean or anything like that. So it's been a boat that has really gained a lot of notoriety, mainly in Europe and in Australia. We've had trouble with the 3200 in the United States, mainly because the 3200 in its design was not a boat designed to be a full IRC cruiser, and it was not a boat designed for light winds. And unfortunately, in North America, a lot of the racing we do, certainly in the Great Lakes and on the East Coast, is light wind based. And the boat wasn't as good as its rating below 10 knots of breeze. It sailed badly, but you're only as good as what you can sail versus everybody else. And that boat had a poor ratio for that sort of thing. So that was one of the things we wanted to fix with this boat. And that was what you'll see with the 3200 is a boat that is relatively less wide for its length than what we have on the 3200, which of course keeps wetted surface area down, all while keeping, you can see, a very powerful aft section for offshore sailing. So it's a boat that is very good in the light airs. I, you know, for a year we looked at the polars and everything. I can tell you that last week we had a day of almost nothing whatsoever, and we were tacking upwind in 3.2 knots of wind, 25 degrees apparent, tack to tack, and doing 2.6 to 2.7 knots. So it was, so for me, I wasn't convinced until last Friday afternoon, but it'll do the light air work that we need in North America. So it's a very good, very positive development for the project. It's 2 meters 13, which is, it's a little over, it's gonna be close to 7 feet. So, yeah, 6'9", 6'10". As I left the boat on Friday night, I was just buttoning it up, but there was this great sunset, so I snapped a shot. But this dedicated website, I encourage you all to go. We put up news up there at least once, sometimes twice a week. You'll see on there, you'll find the VPPs, the electronics packages, all the data, both on the 3200 and the 3600. News, photos, drawings, technical information, all of that is online on the site. So. It's a good spot to get it. And to give you an idea of the timing of what we have coming to the market, we put the prototype in the water here at the end of August. It went to the La Rochelle Boat Show, where it was launched 2 weeks ago. We will then take the boat also to the Paris Boat Show. So for anybody who's coming in December, you'll see the boat there in Paris. The first boats will come off the line in mid to late January. So we'll have, right now we're still in a testing phase. In fact, the boat left yesterday morning to do a tour of the Bay of Biscay, so up to the northern part of France and down to the tip of Spain and back, because we decided that a boat like this, you can't just test it by going out for an afternoon. It had to be put through its paces, and they are, unfortunately, or fortunately for us, encountering between 30 and 35 knots of breeze, upwind. So it's a good, if anything's been a break, we would prefer to do it right now. Not too much, but a little bit is always good. If you break nothing on the boat, you weren't trying hard enough. So they're off doing that, and unfortunately, I have to come here, so. But I guess we'll have the same weather, so we'll see. And so the boats will be, so we wanted to have that time to make sure the boat is exactly the way we want it. We've already changed bits and pieces of it, but nothing major. And so we'll bring the production online in December for boats at the end of January. We'll do this is a racing series in France, so we'll do this. That'll be where we do a lot of our communication about the prototype boat. It'll be racing in this series in the spring in France. We have the possibility of doing a North American debut for the boat, possibly in Oakland at the Pacific Sail Expo show. We have a boat headed off to the Asia Pacific market. It will be launched there in May. We have already a lot of 3200s in Australia, so we want to make sure we get a 3600 out there as well. We also have a lot of interest coming from the southern part of China around Hainan for this type of boat. And then the transponder race, which is this transatlantic race, is done in two parts. The first part leaves in July 2014 and goes from San Jose on the Atlantic coast to the island of Madeira. And then they come back the following January, so January 2015, and go from Madeira to Martinique. So we'll use that also as a way to communicate about the boat. But boats will be available in this time period here for spring and certainly for summer sailing here in North America if you have clients that are interested.
Where are they being built?
We're building them just not so far from where we are. We're building them about 35 kilometers from our main facility.
Okay.
So what is the total of 3200s that were built for American?
I believe there's four or five. So it's not, it wasn't, whereas we have some markets where we have, like in Norway, I've got 25 of them. So it's.
And who would you say your competition is for, let's say, 3600s?
It's going to depend a little bit on the program that people are going to use. Now, if you have, you get a little bit of a presence here in North America from people like Archambault, for example. So that would be obviously a much more direct competitor for the type of program. When you look at pure sort of inshore IRC racing, you'll have it's facing off with everybody. You'll have the first series will be there, even though it'll be a little bit less high tech, but a little bit less expensive. And then you have everybody from J-Bo to the Fars and so forth that are in front of you. So it's a real race boat in the racing market. So it's something that you have to feel comfortable working with those clients because it's.
Now, as a realist, I don't think too many dealers are ever going to stock one. But do you think?